with accuracy. It was a mastermind, according to the police. We know it is difficult. We understand your case. But that doesn't mean in the name of interrogation, you pick up a few innocent people. We can understand. But thousands, what message are you sending? Do you think my lecture will be effective? Maybe I will be able to convince 2, 3%, 5%, not more than that. So we have to solve the problem. What is the root problem? And the police should get the confidence of the citizens. If that is not there, how will they be able to stop terrorism? And if you want respect, you should give respect. There were good policemen also. Many of my friends who are advocates and lawyers, they told me that there were good policemen who helped the people when they were harassed. Some of the policemen had a very good heart. They helped them, they supported them. But generally, oh, you have a beard. Why do you have a beard? Oh, you have trousers above the ankle. Why do you keep it? Wearing a cap. As though it is mentioned in the rule book, a terrorist should have a beard, should have trousers above the ankle and a cap. Then I would be number one terrorist. Even I have my trousers above the ankle, I'm wearing a cap and I have a beard. What signals are you sending? There should be a proper training, a proper understanding of the religion of Islam. That's what William, when he advised, he told the US government that you don't know Islam. George Bush doesn't know Islam at all. It was the article that came yesterday in the midday. He doesn't know. Unless you don't understand, how will you be able to solve the problem? I don't want the police to misunderstand me. When I tell the Muslims that killing innocent people is wrong, though many Muslims disagree with me, Quran condemns it. Our Prophet condemned it. Killing any innocent human being, you can't justify it. I have to speak the truth. At the same time, I even have to speak the truth to the police force. I hope they understand the situation. And according to Julio Ribeiro, he writes an article in Hindustan Times, I think it was the 9th of September, he says that more the unnecessary arrests that are made to get a breakthrough becomes more difficult proportionately. The more unnecessary people you arrest, the chances you get at the real culprit is more difficult. On the 2nd of September, 2006, there was a good gesture by the police commissioner of Bombay, A.N. Roy. He wrote a personal letter to a couple of hundred Muslim leaders saying that the investigation is unbiased, we aren't harassing the Muslims. I too received one of these letters. And he said that if there is any query, any questions, we can come and sit across the table. We can talk. It's a good gesture. The letter came recently, just maybe a week back. I only hope it is not a theoretical exercise of public relations. If it's practically implemented that innocent Muslims should not be harassed, if you really want to get the confidence, you see to it that you get the confidence of the Muslims. And then only you will be really able to catch the culprits. And if you get the culprits, whoever they are, surely they have to be punished. We know the authorities, they tell us that why majority Muslims have been picked up. The argument given was that when we analyze that in Punjab terrorism, majority people arrested, they were Sikh. In Ulfa, in Assam, majority were Hindus. In Tamil Nadu LTT, they were Hindus. So but naturally in Bombay, because you know we think it's linked with Pakistan, Kashmir, it would be Muslims. I agree with you for sake of argument. If a terrorist attack is done in Punjab, the majority of people living in Punjab are Sikh. So if majority Sikhs are arrested, it is logical. In Assam, majority are Hindus, so if Hindus are arrested, it is logical. In Tamil Nadu, majority of people living are Hindus, so Hindus are arrested, logical. In Bombay, are the majority of people living Muslims? The Muslims are in minority. So why are they being picked up in majority? If you think it's an act of Kashmir militant, if you have got records, we have got no doubt with that. But do you mean to say the LTT can't come to Bombay? Do you mean to say Ulfa can't come to Bombay? Do you mean to say Sikh terrorists can't come to Bombay? You cannot say 100% this act has been Muslim. You can say high possibilities. And if you show proof, we are with you. What we are trying to tell you, that identify the people who are responsible, catch them and punish them. But not thousands of people, innocent Muslims being rounded up. We know there are several records. Just a couple of months back, according to the ATS of Maharashtra, 16 members were arrested from a hardcore Hindu organization. They were involved in 3 bomb blasts in mosques. Mahmoudi Mosque in Parbani, one of the mosques in Jalna, one in Pune, three. And recently on 6th of April, in one place, by mistake, a bomb detonates by mistake. While they were making a bomb, it exploded. It killed 4 people and 11 were injured. When inquiries were made, many people belonged to the same hardcore Hindu organization. And they found there that the plan was that to attack the mosque in the guise of Sikh. You know, this took place and none did. Sikh, why? Because there was a rift going on between the Muslims and Sikh. A Sikh girl married a Muslim boy, so there was tension, so they wanted to take advantage. So they wanted to do an act in the guise of Sikh. There are cases we know that Hindus have attacked wearing caps and beards. So you can't say 100% Muslims are involved. Maybe high possibilities, I'm not saying no. Recently, a few days back, on Friday, 8th of September, 4 bomb blasts took place in Malegaon. One outside one of the mosques, one outside a graveyard, in which 35 innocent Muslims were killed and more than 100 innocent Muslims were injured. Again, prime suspect, LET. Can be, but not prime. Imagine, it is a game plan. It's a name game. If you go to America, it's Al-Qaeda. Here it is LET. According to an article that came in the DNA on the 6th of September, a person by the name of Joseph, he writes that the foreign experts, they tell that if you involve yourself too much in the blame game, you lose focus and the main culprits are never caught. You do a proper investigation. If really they're caught, they have to be punished. Irrespective whether the terrorists are Muslims or non-Muslims, whether they belong to Kashmir, whether to Pakistan, whether Ulfa, whether LTT, if they are proved to be involved in that, they should be punished. I am not here to support any terrorist act, not at all. But if you want to get to the bottom of it, you should know that this should be done meticulously. We should take the citizens in confidence. One of the other cause is the media. Mainly that media which is controlled by the politicians. We have to be careful of this. And this media, they can convert black to white, day to night, hero into a villain, villain into hero. And we see that very often. If you see my tapes, I've given very such examples. But in India, it's fortunate that the more popular media is not controlled by the politicians. And we find that this media really gave the true picture. Whether it be the Gujarat riots, the Bombay riots in 93, or even today, the innocent Muslims are being harassed. The media, whether it be the newspaper, the news channels, they have really given a true picture of what's happening. Not 100%. Sometimes they get involved in news which is sensational. So when they get the news without checking up, they give it. It's sensational, they give it. But as a whole, we have to agree, the media has been honest. I'm talking about non-Muslim media. I'm not talking about the Muslim media. And here we find that they were honest and they projected the real picture. But what we have to be careful is of the media which is controlled by the politicians. And as far as the judiciary system is concerned in India, the innocent citizen of India, especially the Muslim victims, we have faith in the Indian judiciary system. Though some people say that some are corrupt, they are blasphemed in the committee, but as a whole, we know most of the judges, they're upright and they're honest. We only hope that these people are not influenced by the politicians. So far, I know most of the judges, they don't care much for the politicians. If once the politicians get hold of the judiciary system, then God save this country. Yet, we have faith in the judiciary system. And to conclude, we have to realize that since we know that the cause of terrorism is injustice, the cause of terrorism is wrongdoing to a particular group of people, this thing should be stopped. How can we stop? As I mentioned, number one, the politicians, they should be honest, they should be just. They should not go for the vote bank and do things which are wrong. Once they're honest and they're just, irrespective they lose their seat, you see to it that terrorism will stop. Point number two, the innocent Indian citizens, they should not be instigated by the politicians and do wrong things and kill other innocent human beings. Point number three, the police, they should be upright. They should be just. If someone is being harmed, they should see to it that he's protected. They should not be ploy of the politicians. I know there are times that they can be transferred, but if every policeman in India is honest, the new policeman who